Sexual harassment is an unwelcome act of sexual advances in request of sexual favors and other verbal or physical conduct of a sexual nature. It is also unlawful to harass a person like an employee on the basis of gender. About 60% of women have been reported to have been sexually harassed in the workplace, while about 12% of men have been harassed sexually as well. Sexual harassment in the workplace is very common, as it needs to be brought more awareness to others about that issue. About 75% of victims of sexual harassment do not report it due to the fears of the consequences. This project will highlight the importance of putting an end to sexual harassment within the workplace. Movements like the Me Too movement have inspired the victims of sexual harassment, which helped them become comfortable enough to report their experiences. This discussion will help educate the public on what the sexual harassment is and bring the community together. As Jalen Natera, a student at Old Westbury College and residential assistant on the campus, had the privilege to talk with two students from the college about their experiences with sexual harassment.
We're walking out to support women and to protest the way that this company has handled sexual harassment cases. Real change and bring attention to the issue.
So my name is Adeline Ferris. I attend the institution called SUNY Old Westbury. It's a college in Old Westbury. And then as well as my major is a psychology major with a minor in Islamic cultures.
Hello, my name is Quentin Bullins. My major is finance with a minor in sports management. And the college I attend is SUNY Old Westbury.
What do you consider sexual harassment in the workplace?
I consider sexual harassment in the workplace to be considered a behavior characterized by unwelcoming sexual remarks or work advancements to a employee or anybody in a workplace that you share that makes the person feel uncomfortable or threatened in that sense.
I believe sexual harassment in the workplace to be anything along the lines of physical, verbal, and emotional harassment.
Have you yourself ever experienced sexual harassment in the workplace? And if you did, how did that make you feel?
Regarding of experiencing sexual harassment in the workplace and how did it make me feel, I, yes, have had sexual remarks, I guess you could say given towards me. But however, a majority of the time, I witnessed sexual harassment continually by my managers or co-workers to a co-worker of mine or, you know, or a friend of mine, I can consider. When it had happened, yes, it makes you extremely uncomfortable because this is somebody in a higher position than you or somebody you work side to side with that is very close proximity in you that it makes you feel as though uneasy. And it's supposed to be like a place, you know, you're making money, this is not your home, but however, you should be comfortable in the place that you work. So it makes you feel very uneasy, if that's the way to say it.
I have actually dealt with numerous of sexual harassment in the workplace. The way it made me feel at first before I noticed it was sexual harassment is that, like, I appreciated the attention. It was the compliments, they were great. But then when I noticed the sexual harassment, I began to feel like an object, something that was only categorized in the realms of anything sexual and made me feel less of a human.
So as an advocate against sexual harassment in the workplace, what advice would you give victims on when they are experiencing that?
Advice I would give somebody who's been a victim or who's experiencing it, which I would actually like to give myself as advice, would be don't be afraid to say something. You know, don't just take the remark and be like, well, you know, that's just my manager and the way he speaks to me, you know, that's just how he speaks. No, it's not. And if it makes you feel uncomfortable or inappropriate, it's inappropriate, you know, say something. Hey, I don't like the way you speak to me. And if it continues, then you bring it up to a higher person. And if they shut you down, then go even bigger, because what is happening, you're probably not the first person and you will not be the last in that sense if you don't speak up.
If you're finding it hard for someone to believe you that you're being sexually harassed, try to at least tell a coworker that you're really close with to possibly watch your back and see if you can possibly catch the assailant in action, so that you now have a witness to back up your statement, so that now you can bring it to the boss and see if not the person gets fired, but at least the person can have like some type of stern talking to at least get the situation under control and back in your hands.